My name is Jared Stang. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Physics and Astronomy here. My job is mostly teaching, but I also do some research as well.
I'm Amanda. I'm a postdoctoral researcher who works on animal development.
I'm Andy. I'm a fourth year physics major and also minor in math.
I do research in physics education, so that's how students learn physics and how we can teach it to them better.
So I study actually how the cells that make up the embryo move across the embryo during development. And this is really important because cells move to make the different tissues, and they also move in different diseases like cancer.
I started off in biomedical research, and I've completed some projects in neuroscience and psychology. From there, I realized I had an excitement for data, and now I'm pursuing computational and data science work.
In my research, we use a lot of mixed methods. So trying to understand how students do in physics, we use some performance metrics, how they do on tests, but also a lot of social science techniques like surveys, focus groups, interviews.
I worked on a project to estimate greenhouse gas emissions of vehicles on the road based on data in the city of Surrey.
I work with lab mice, and what we do is we actually derive different types of cells from the mouse embryos themselves. We look at those cells using a microscope and we image them to look at the proteins that are on the surface of the cells, and that pattern of what the surface of the cells look like can tell us a lot about how the cells stick and move in their environment.
My first research experience was after my second year of undergrad. Because I was interested in doing more physics, I wanted to do something related to my degree. My research looks differently. It's not physics, but it's about physics education. But I find it really valuable to help me learn more about what I'm doing in the classroom and the impact that I'm having on my students.
So I actually took a class in my fourth year of undergrad that actually got me into research. That actually made me change my major, be a high school teacher, to wanting to go to grad school and start my PhD program.
In high school, I had the opportunity to shadow researchers at UBC's Heart and Lung Innovation. From there, I was able to apply to some summer research opportunities that they offered. I applied, but I didn't get it the first round. I applied again the following year, and I got it.
It's something that offers you much greater learning opportunity than you can find in the classroom, plus a really great opportunity to make good relationships with instructors, with professors, with other research assistants.
If you're thinking about getting into research and you don't get it the first time, then keep trying.
I started with almost no lab skills whatsoever, and even jumping into grad school in general, I had very little research experience just besides that class. So I say just go for it.